Hello, everybody! Welcome! This is my stream! We're playing Fighting Fantasy! Welcome in! I never really know how to start my streams, and I think because I've taken a long break, I'm like just nervous. I'm excited to get started, but I just never really know what to say. So yes, welcome, and we're doing Fighting Fantasy. Fighting Fantasy is a choose your own adventure style book, but we are doing it with a twist. So these are meant to be played as a solo game, but today I'm going to be the narrator, and we're going to have a guest adventurer on this week, and we have a new adventurer every week. This is season 4 of our Fighting Fantasy streams. And welcome in, we've got lots of new followers today. Killer Kitten, welcome in, thank you for the follow, welcome to the Swords Up Club. We are gonna have a new adventurer every single week. And oh my god, Colleen is here! Colleen, I've missed you so much, how are you doing? Let's see if your command still works, shall we? Does it still work? I want you. Yay, it still works. Yeah, I've missed you, Colleen. Oh my goodness, how you doing? You're good-ish? Oh, let's catch up soon. But yes, it's a choose your own adventure style book that we're doing. I have a new adventure on every week. I'm just the narrator. And if you like adventure, if you like stuff like D&D or any sort of RPG, then I think you'll enjoy this. There's gonna be fighting, there's gonna be battles, there's gonna be dice rolling, there's gonna be choices to make, there's gonna be enemies to face, treasure to be had, and most of all, my favorite thing, death! Lots and lots of death and suffering. So I'm very much looking forward to that. What else do I need to tell you? All the beautiful sounds that you're hearing today are courtesy of Sirenscape. If you want some wonderful sounds for your tabletop role-playing games, then go and check them out. You can get a 30-day free trial right now at sirenscape.com. And if you follow them on their social media, you will have seen my face quite a lot because I do their socials. I work for them. So yeah, go and grab yourself a free trial and get yourself some epic sounds for your epic games. What else do I need to cover today? I don't know, I've forgotten how to stream, but I hope everyone is super well. If you like all of that sort of stuff, then stick around because I think you'll really enjoy this show. I think I'm just gonna roll the intro and we're just gonna get into it because I've forgotten how to do my job. So let's roll this beautiful intro video and stick around for some gruesome adventures and lots of torture and death. That's what we like here. A year after a champion was crowned, we're heading back into Death Trap Dungeon. And this time, it's deadlier than ever. Can you survive? The Trial of Champions. That video was made by Patch from QuestJunkies UK, makes all the best intros. Let's give him a little shout out, shall we? Shout out to QuestJunkies UK. Go and follow Patch. Patch is awesome. They do D&D and all of that. Melakisa says, I absolutely love your voice. Thank you. I'm very British. You're going to have a lot of my voice for the next couple of hours. What else should I tell you about this show? I don't know. It's going to be awesome. This is season 4, like I said. Oh, and before I forget, why would anyone want to be an adventurer on this show and put themselves through so much torture? It's because they can win a prize! Woo! Prizes! They can win a copy of the book if they want. I will send it to them. And every adventurer gets a beautifully crafted virtual certificate of participation, whether they make it through or not. And look at this, we have a spangly new leaderboard. Ta-da! I made this. We've got a leaderboard now. Hopefully they'll make it onto the leaderboard. We had Phoenixy Wacky on last week, our first victim, and unfortunately they were eliminated. So to make it onto the leaderboard, you'll make it on as eliminated if you die, that's fine. But if you want to make it onto the leaderboard and try to win a copy of the book, then the adventurer needs to complete the adventure, make it out alive, and they will make it onto the leaderboard. Yeah, we've got a fancy new leaderboard. We've never had one of those before. It pops in and out. I'm really pleased with that. So to win the book, all they need to do is make it out of my deadly dungeon and stay alive and do it in the quickest time. What else? I don't know. That is it. Let's just get on with it, shall we? Because I have waffled. Oh, we have new emotes as well, made by Scarlet Song. I have a waffle command now. There we go, waffle, Vicky is waffling again. We have some wonderful new emotes, so get in on those. Let's just meet the adventurer and crack on, because I have just talked a load of crap and flapped my mouth for too long. Hello, adventurer!
Good morning, or I should say good afternoon, Vicky. How are you?
I am really good and awkward, and I've forgotten how to stream and all of the things, so you're gonna help me out. Over to you. Who are you, please? I'll give you a shout out.
It's so early here on the west coast of the United States, I barely remember. But if I were to make something up, I'd say I'm DM Charlie from DM Charlie Gaming and DM Charlie Gaming here on Twitch. We run a weekly Icewind Dale campaign. I and five of my goofy buddies just trying to ham-hand our way through Icewind Dale. So that's who I am.
That's who you are. Excellent. Awesome. And you are going to be playing as...
Aubrey Edmund Horatio Whitcomb, explorer extraordinaire. Pleasure to make your acquaintance, Mum.
Fantastic. And are you going to be doing the voice all the way through? Are you going to be in character?
What, hey, absolutely, of course.
Awesome, excellent. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Aubrey, and I will we'll roll some stats for you once you've introduced yourself as your character.
Excellent. Aubrey is a traditional sailor, a gentleman's gentleman. An explorer, corsair, privateer, a man of action, not afraid to do some daring do, kick in doors and say, what hey, buddy, have at you. With a flashing bit of blade and panache, I shall win through the day and come out victorious in the end. And I shall finish with a nice cup of tea.
I am very much looking forward to putting you for your paces, because all of that is going to be stripped away very, very soon.
And a crystalline tear shall roll down my manly cheek.
Let's roll you some stats, shall we? Let's see. You are going to have three stats. You're going to have skill, which is your, skill with a blade, of course. You're going to have your stamina, which is your health, and you're going to have your luck, which we can use in battles or any other way that we need to throughout the book. So first of all, let's find out how good you are with that blade of yours. I need you to roll 1d6 and add 6.
1d6
and add 6. Yep.
A 3.
You have a skill of 9.
Alright.
Okay, we need some stamina for you. Let's see how healthy you are. I need you to roll both dice and add 12.
Alright, Aubrey, let's go.
A 7, so a 19.
19 stamina. And luck is just 1d6 plus 6.
Ooh.
Come on.
Hello, dice gods. A 2.
Oh, no. Only 8 luck. Okay. Ooh, okay. Well, you may struggle a little bit where we're going, but let's see, shall we? So you have a skill of 9, a stamina of 19, and a luck of 8. Fabulous. So you guys at home, you'll notice there's a couple of things on the screen there. Last week, I gave John from Phoenix Iwaki, we started off with 3 hearts, but I felt like that was far too generous. So going forward, I'm only going to give each adventurer 2 lives. Because...
Oh, my wife's gonna love the fact that you started to get meaner. Harder with me. Meaner, yeah.
Yeah, meaner. If your wife enjoys people being mean to you, she's gonna love this show.
She is one killer kitten in
the
chat right
now. Oh, fantastic.
So.
Okay, please don't be gentle. Do not worry. There's no gentleness here at all. Only torture. So you've got two lives, but you'll notice there is the chance to give the adventurer a bonus life by donating £10. If you feel they are entertaining enough and you want them to continue, if you feel that they may need a bonus life, then please consider donating. There will be a donation link coming up in the chat every so often. I think you can also do it down in my panels, maybe, perhaps. But there we go. There's also a timer at the bottom there. I am going to be timing each attempt. So every life they have is an attempt. I will be timing those. And if they make it onto the leaderboard, then that survival time will go onto the leaderboard. It's also a great way for me to track save points. So one thing that we've introduced throughout this book, obviously a few video game rules are not going to hurt anything. And we found that adding save points throughout just means that should Charlie's character die, when they come back, they get to respawn at a save point. And it just keeps everything moving along. It's more interesting for us, more interesting for you. And that is the best way forward. So I'll be timing some save points as well. When you hit a save point, I'll record it on here and I'll let you know that you've done that. When you respawn from your death, you'll come back with full stamina, but your skill, luck, and any of the items, important items in your inventory, they'll go back to how they were at your save point. Does that make sense?
Understood.
Fantastic. I don't think there's anything else that I need to... Any more housekeeping? I don't think there's any more housekeeping. So without further ado, Charlie, if you're ready, I'm ready. Shall we find out how Aubrey Edmund Horatio Whitcomb came to be taking part in the Trial of Champions?
Absolutely.
And you can hear me okay? Have we got any audio issues this week?
None whatsoever.
Fabulous. If you do happen to not be able to hear me for whatever reason, you may ask me to repeat stuff. That is absolutely fine. The timer will start when you make your first decision. We've got Llama Chameleon in here as well. Good luck to you, adventurer. You'll need it.
I have to do this here. Llama, 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 llama chameleon. I hope that's what they were intending.
I hope so.
They'll disappear now.
They come and go. They come and go. All Stray Maidens here as well. And you guys, every season I do a clips reel. So if you find anything funny that you want to clip, then please clip away. Get clip happy. I would love you to clip those things. Those things may make it into the season clip reel. And I'm going to try and get better at putting them onto my social media accounts as well. But because I work in social media, my personal accounts get shoved to one side. Good luck against the evil Vicky. Yes, I actually have some emotes of me being evil, so if you like emotes of me being evil, then that's great. Fruterra, welcome in. Welcome to the Swords Up Club.
She'll kill me for admitting this, but that is my very talented daughter. She is probably watching to see Dad get his own.
Excellent. Right, let's get some evil emotes in here, shall we? So after being, Clippy became an adventurer. Nope. Let's get some evil emotes in here. I'm going to spam my own evil emotes because they're new and I'm really pleased with them. So thank you to Scarlet Song for making those. Right, let's find out how Aubrey Edmund Horatio Whitcomb came to be taking part in the Trial of Champions. It is another fiercely hot day, and the temperature in the sticky gloom below decks is unbearable. The air is thick with the acrid smell of sweating bodies. No one is allowed to speak, and the only noise to be heard above the monotonous creaking of the ship is the regular sharp crack of a whip and the agonized cry which follows it. "Row harder, you dogs!" shouts the one-eyed overseer as he cracks the whip once again. "Enjoy this pleasant voyage while you can, because you'll wish you were back on board after a day or two where we're going." Chained to a bench and straining hard at the long oar which you pull with two other galley slaves, your mind drifts back to that unfortunate day 1 week ago when you were captured. You'd left Port Black Sand in a small boat to sail south to the coast to Oyster Bay. As ill luck would have it, a galley appeared on the horizon headed in your direction. It drew steadily closer, and it was not long before your boat was crushed under its bows and you were forced to dive into the sea. There was nothing you could do except climb up a rope that was thrown down to you, Your boat had become nothing more than a few pieces of broken wood floating aimlessly on the sea. It was useful to struggle as a crew of 20 hardened cutthroats surrounded you. Since that cursed day, you've been chained to your oar, rowing to the point of collapse towards an unknown destination. Suddenly you hear a shout of, "Land ahoy!" and you begin to wonder what evil awaits you. An hour later, you feel the ship bump up against a jetty, and there's more shouting as the ship is finally moored. You're dragged from the ship with the other slaves, and you see in the glaring sunlight that you're on a small island. A somber-looking castle sits on top of the island, and next to it there is a semi-ruined amphitheatre. A man wearing black chainmail armour hands Captain Bartella a bag of coins. He orders his men back to the ship, and you watch them set sail. The man in the black armour steps forward, saying, "You're now the property of Lord Carnus. It's your honour to die for his pleasure in the arena of death here on Blood Island. Only one of you will survive, and he, or she, will represent Lord Carnus in Fang at the next Trial of Champions. Baron Suckenvit has modified his deadly labyrinth and is now offering 20,000 gold pieces to anyone who gets through it. Of course, Lord Carnus will keep your prize if you get through, but you'll be spared your life. Baron Suckenvit's reputation suffered greatly last year when someone succeeded in getting through the labyrinth, but now he boasts that no one can survive his new dungeon. Lord Carnus would like one of you to make Suckenvit eat his words. You must understand he hates his brother's fame. Now, follow me." You are led up the hill to a castle where you're locked in a cell in the depths of the lower chambers, sharing the dark cell with four others: a stout dwarf, a man-orc, a sinewy easterner, and a bold, muscle-bound man. The mood is grim, and few words are spoken as each of you ponders the impending combat. 42 slaves have arrived by ship, and only one will survive. The dubious reward is entry to a deadly dungeon. Yikes.
Sounds like another Wednesday. Oh, what a day.
At dawn the following day, which is possibly Thursday, you are woken by the sound of heavy footsteps approaching down the corridor. A key turns in the lock of the door, and two guards wearing black chainmail enter, carrying trays of food. "Eat well," says one of them, "as you'll need all your strength to survive the day. By the end of it, you may all be dead." The guard then turns to you and offers you some bread and a bowl of soup. And it's now that Aubrey Edmund Horatio Whitcomb, the slave, starting with nothing, gets to make his first decision. So no blades for you, no provisions for you, no armour, nothing. You're starting as a slave with absolutely nothing, and someone has offered you some soup and bread. Would you like to take the bread, or would you like to try to overcome the guard?
Well, having been rowing for several days since my untimely capture by those corsairs, I think it's best that I fill my stomach, as I am famished and I need to restore my strength.
You are going to
take the bread.
Take some food. Okay, we're going to head to page 49. You may write that down if you wish. Let's go to page 49 and see what happens to you. Have you played one of these before, by the way, Charlie?
Years and years and years ago, when I was middle school. Yeah.
Cool.
Long time.
Long time. Okay. The soup. Have you ever played this one?
No.
Excellent. No, okay. So the soup is thick with chicken and vegetables and it tastes delicious. You devour it greedily and you mop up the last drops with the bread. You've not eaten well for a fortnight, and you now feel fit and ready for the coming ordeal. When you've all finished eating, you are led away to begin the first day in the arena of death. Page 22. You're in the middle of the procession of 42 slaves, which wends its way along various corridors until you reach the amphitheatre. The sun is already beating down, making the sand in the arena uncomfortably hot on your bare feet. You're seated high in the stands is a dark hooded figure surrounded by guards. You watch him raise to his feet and lift his arms into the air, commanding silence. You know why you are here, Lord Carnus begins. It is my wish to be represented in the Trial of Champions. Some of you will die today, some tomorrow, and more the following day, until only one of you is left. To those about to die, I salute you. Lord Carnus sits down again and nods, which signals the start of the proceedings. The slaves are split into seven groups of six, and you find yourself in a group accompanied by an elf, two northmen, a dwarf, and an ogre. Your group is chosen first, and you're told that the first event is a race to test strength and stamina. A crude sack containing several heavy rocks is strapped to your back. You watch as burning coals are brought into the arena and poured over a section of the makeshift racetrack. The six of you are then lined up at the start, each carrying your burden, and you're told to race around the track until one of you is lapped or collapses, and then you're off. You all jostle for position on the way to jumping the first pile of burning coals. Do you wish to set the pace, or would you rather stay at the back?
Don't want to blow my stamina too early. I'm going to follow the pack and determine who is the leader, then overtake them towards the end.
Fabulous. So you're going to stay at the back. Page 107.
I'm nervous.
Malachisa says, I had a bunch of these, but I can't even remember which ones I've done. That's all right. One of the Northmen takes the lead, setting a fast pace. Round and round the arena you run, gritting your teeth harder each time you jump over the burning coals. After 20 minutes, nobody has been left behind, and the Northman increases his stride. I'd like you to throw two dice.
A five.
A five. That is less than your skill score. Let's turn to page 360. The Northman increases his lead over the rest of you, but you feel you still have a lot in reserve should he come close to lapping the pack. When he gets within 10 feet of catching up, everybody decides to sprint. There are only two runners ahead of you, but you do not look back. Suddenly, there's an agonized cry followed by a shout, which calls an end to the race. The dwarf lies prostrate in the sand, having collapsed just as the Northman caught up with him. You are led back to your cells, and the dwarf is quickly put to death before the start of the next race. Turn to page 136.
Show absolutely uncivilized.
136. When all the races are finished and the survivors are back in their cells, you discover that the bald man does not return. Now there are only three others left in your cell. Although exhausted, you find it difficult to fall asleep. Your mind is occupied with what challenge the next day may bring. In the morning you're fed, and then one by one the slaves are led away back to the arena. Eventually your turn comes. And when you reach the door to the arena, you're told to choose a weapon. Would you like to choose a broadsword and shield, or a trident and a net?
I will go with the broadsword and shield, being it what it was most closely what I was trained in as a youth.
Okay, you've gone for the broadsword and shield. Let's turn to 275. Yeah. A guard opens the door to the arena and you step out onto the hot sand, which is now stained red with the blood of fallen combatants. Suddenly another door in the arena wall opens, and out steps the dreaded Bone Crusher Beast. Its tough, leathery skin glistening in the sun. You're about to face this thing?
Gasp!
Oh,
what manner of monstrosity is this thing?
That's a Bone Crusher Beast. Its ugly head is small and has two narrow, near-blind eyes, a flat nose and tendrils hanging over its taut mouth. Its torso, however, is massive, and its long arms are dauntingly powerful. You are going to fight it with the broadsword and shield, page 56.
Those in my inventory at this point.
They're not permanent, they're just for this one fight. Yeah. Yeah, they're just for this one fight. You curse your choice of weapon. Oh, goddammit. You know that swords make little impression on the iron-like hide of a Bone Crusher Beast. There's only one way to slay a Bone Crusher, and that would be to make it fall to the ground, whereupon its delicate balance would be totally destroyed and would be impossible for the Bone Crusher to ever stand again. You'll have to chop at its legs while trying to avoid its fatal grip. Now, first battle.
Great.
First battle, so you've chosen the wrong weapon here to fight the Bone Crusher Beast. You've got your first battle. So on your adventure sheet, you should have some, you know how this works, right? You've got your monster encounter boxes. It's got a skill of 9 and a stamina of 10.
All right.
And because we're in the arena, I'm just gonna keep the arena music going. I'm not gonna switch over to battle music. We're gonna roll our 2d6 at the same time and add our skill. We both have the same skill, so it is just contested rolls. Whoever rolls the highest will win the round and deal some damage. Okay. So, guys in the chat, if you have channel points, you can re-roll my dice. You can also give Charlie a +2 to his dice, but the +2s are limited. There's only 2 available per stream, so use them wisely. Okay? Shall we roll? Let's see.
Aubrey has made a mistake.
Oh! I say, take a 6, you!
Oh, I got a 6 and a 5, so you just about get him. So he's down to 8 stamina. Ooh, let's go! 9, 10, 11, 12. I got a 17 here.
Ooh, I have seemed to have rolled snake eyes, a 1.
Oh. No, so you get hit. You lose 2 stamina, and it says as soon as you lose an attack round, turn to page 343. That's never good, is it?
No.
Oh, crikey! My spleen!
I died already.
The Bone Crusher manages to grab your sword arm and break it as though it were a twig. Without releasing your arm, it grabs your neck with its other arm, snaps your neck with a similar ease, and the arena has eliminated another candidate.
9 freaking minutes? I survived 9 minutes?
Oh my god. I think that might be the quickest death.
Wow.
Big oof. Big oof.
Wow.
Sad trombone for you, I'm afraid.
Ugh. Wow, that's it. This was great. Thank you. Enjoyed the experience.
I say, blast! Blast and jam!
Goodness, you didn't even reach a save point.
Oh my goodness.
You didn't even reach a save point.
That is, oh.
That is brutal.
That is, can you grin any wider, Vicky? Can you grin any wider?
I love it when people die.
Oh my goodness.
yeah, this is great. I think we need to head right back to the beginning.
All right.
Next week on Vicky's murder stream. We actually don't have an adventurer for next week, so guys in chat, if you fancy having a crack at this, Colleen, I'm looking at you, my wifey, if anyone is available at this time next week and wants to come on, send me a DM. But yeah, I think for now, I think we need to head back right back to the very start.
So reset my stamina.
Reset everything. Yeah, I'm just gonna reset this timer, but I don't like how it's laid out. So, just bear with me. You've got plans, Colleen. No worries. That's fine. No worries at all. I just thought I'd open it up to you, seeing as you're my awesome person that I love to have on. Let's have a little look here. Okay, that looks like a nice timer. Let's reset that to zero.
That was embarrassing.
That was tough. Now that timer doesn't look right either. They've changed. So the timer that I'm using, they've changed it, and it just looks weird now. It just looks ever so strange, and I can't get used to it. Edit layout time. I should have got this all sorted beforehand. This does sound fun, and you think you're free. Okay, well, Malakisa, drop me a DM, and we'll have a chat, and let's see if you could be a good fit. That looks about right, doesn't it, for the timer?
I mean, congrats. That's...
that was harsh. Right, so here, you have one life left, so one more attempt. Unless someone gives you a bonus life. Let me just check that timer is still enabled, because it doesn't seem to be coming up. Colleen says, do it. That's how I started my marriage with her. That is very true. Me and Colleen met in Death Trap Dungeon. She'd never been on the stream before. So that was pretty cool that happened. Right. So you didn't even make it through. That's hilarious. Right. Just bear with me, guys. I'm just going to take a quick drink.
I deserve it, though, because I told Phoenix my only goal of today was to beat him. So pride goeth before the fall. You know, I got my comeuppance. Now it's time to go straight through.
Well, let's hope you can at least make it onto the leaderboard. I mean, you don't want to be you don't want to be eliminated, right? No?
Right.
You don't want to be eliminated. That's the only way to beat Phoenix, would be to not be eliminated.
I don't want to be eliminated. I don't want to slink away in ignominious defeat, tail between my legs.
I love what Retro Ted has just said. He says, is that the equivalent of dying in the tutorial? Yes, we didn't even make it into the dungeon, guys. We've not even made it into the dungeon, which is I would say that's very embarrassing. You should be
beat
very...
Beat him to the quickest death. Wow, yeah. These guys are brutal. They
yes,
are brutal.
Kate. Beating him to the quickest death, at least. I think that's possibly the quickest death that we've had across all four seasons. Does anyone... People who've been watching all four seasons of this, all the previous three, do you think anyone's died within 9 minutes before? Because I don't think so. I don't think anyone has died that quickly.
Just
can you play
us? I'm covered with the stink of my failure. I understand.
I love the word stench. The stench of your failure. The stench.
The stench of my failure.
What can we see here? Cases. Can you play as the Bone Crusher Beast? He seems like a strong boy. Colleen says, I don't think we've had a 9 minute death. No. Can you set Aubrey's hair on fire? Well, Killer Kitten, if he makes it to a certain point in this dungeon, there are some flamey flame flames. And if he doesn't have the right item, then he definitely, almost, mostly, definitely, definitely, mostly, almost, maybe, will be set on fire.
Killer Kitten is one of my players, and... she doesn't react when a mob does damage, but boy, does she react when the mob damages her hair. And that is my comeuppance. So.
God, Colleen, we definitely should have a leaderboard of quickest death. Yes, maybe next season. I think our leaderboard at the moment is looking pretty sweet. But yeah, I think I can definitely. We should award someone. I'm going to actually put that down. 9 minute death.
Maybe 9 minute 23. It was 9:23. I need those 23 seconds.
Tell you what, if you get the quickest death, I will make you a quickest death award at the end of the season. I promise. Someone hold me to that. Don't let me forget. Right. Shall we begin again?
Yeah, absolutely. Quickest death. It's like getting the sportsmanship award. You
Can
know?
We just send him a pity award?
Oh my god.
These guys
wow.
are really brutal. Yes.
Wow.
This is
and
great.
I'm a nice guy.
I'm usually a nice lady.
Wow.
This really...
I want you to know I'm going to take all of this and just spread it on my players, so keep it coming. You fill this tank of angst and anger up.
Okay, let's go, shall we? Thank you for the bits. That's great. You've got it this time. Come on. Vicky's energy rubs off on everybody. Yeah. A pack of band-aids for the quickest death. Yeah. Oh my god, Llama, that's a brilliant idea. But to ship those to America would cost me quite a lot, so maybe not. I can send like virtual band-aids. Right, let's get into it, shall we? So we're not gonna start from the start. We know that your ship has crashed, we know that all of that. You're gonna start in your prison cell. Here we go. I'm gonna lock you up again.
I'm gonna start crying. You all are so mean.
I am loving this. You guys are giving me life right now. It's been thoroughly locked up. There you go. Wow, that one shot's going crazy. Prison doors galore over here. Okay, so at dawn the following day, you're woken by the sound of heavy footsteps approaching down the corridor. A key turns in the lock of the cell door, and two guards wearing black chainmail enter carrying trays of food. Eat well, says one of them, as you'll need your strength to survive the day. By the end of it, you'll all be dead. The guard then turns to you and offers you some bread and a bowl of soup. Do you still want to take the soup, or do you want to try and overcome the guard?
I will eat the soup.
Eat the soup, page 49. Let's hope you can at least make it into the dungeon this time. That would make me very happy. I at least want you to get into the dungeon. Right, the soup is thick with chicken and vegetables, and it tastes delicious. You devour it greedily, and you mop up the last drops with your bread. You've not eaten well for a fortnight, but you now feel fit and ready for the coming ordeal. When you have finished eating, you are led away to begin your first day in the arena of death, and you have to do it all again. You have to do the whole race with the sack on your back and all of that. Let's go. Page 22. You're in the middle of the procession of 42 slaves, which wends its way along various corridors until you reach the amphitheatre. The sun is already beating down, making the sand in the arena uncomfortably hot to your bare feet. Seated high in the stands is a dark-hooded figure surrounded by guards. You watch him rise to his feet and lift his arms into the air, commanding silence. You know why you're here. Basically to give me... lots of entertainment, bloody, bloody, blah. To those about to die, I salute you. We've done this speech before. Lord Carnus sits down again and nods his head to signal the start of the proceedings. The slaves are split into seven groups of six, and you find yourself in a group accompanied by an elf, two northmen, a dwarf, and an ogre. Your group is chosen first, and you're told that the first event is a race to test strength and stamina. A crude sack containing several heavy rocks is strapped to your back. You watch as burning coals are brought into the arena and poured onto a section of the makeshift racetrack. The six of you are then lined up at the start, each carrying your burden, and you're told to race around the track until one of you is lapped or collapses, and then you're off. You all jostle for position on the way to jumping the first pile of burning coals. This time, do you wish to set the pace, or would you rather stay at the back?
With an odd sense of deja vu, I remembered staying at the back led to my survival, so I would stay at the back of the pack again.
I love it when we do the deja vu angle. Stay at the back, page 107. It's like, I feel like I've done this before. One of the Northmen takes the lead, setting a fast pace. Round and round the arena you run, gritting your teeth harder each time you jump over the burning coals. After 20 minutes, nobody's been left behind, and the Northman increases his stride. Throw two dice.
A four.
That is less than your skill score, page 360. The Northman increases his lead over the rest of you, but you feel you still have a lot in reserve should he come close to lapping the pack. When he gets within 10 metres of catching up, everybody decides to sprint. You are only two runners ahead. Oh, sorry, there are only two runners ahead of you, but you do not look back. Suddenly, there's an agonized cry followed by a shout, which calls an end to the race. The dwarf lies prostrate in the sand, having collapsed just as the Northman caught up with him. You are led back to your cells, and the dwarf is quickly put to death before the start of the next race.
Still bad form, still uncivilized.
Turn to page 136. I bet you've never been treated this way before. It's just horrendous.
Absolutely. Stunning.
When all the races are finished and the survivors are back in their cells, you discover that the bald man also does not return. Now there are only three others left in your cell. Although exhausted, you find it difficult to sleep. Your mind is occupied with the challenge that the next day may bring. In the morning, you're fed. And then one by one, the slaves are led away to the arena. Eventually, your turn comes, and when you reach the door to the arena, you're asked to choose your weapon. Broadsword and shield, or trident and net. Make your choice.
Child, I was trained with broadsword and shield, but oddly, I get a queasy feeling in my stomach and opt for that strange net and trident combination.
Okay. Page 275. Let's see, have you chosen wisely?
One would hope.
One would hope. A guard opens the door to the arena, and you step out on the hot sand, which is now stained red with the blood of fallen combatants. Suddenly, another door is opened in the arena wall opposite, and out steps the dreaded bone crusher beast. It's tough. Leathery skin glistening in the sun. Its ugly head is small and houses two narrow, near blind eyes, a flat nose, and tendrils. I love doing this. Tendrils hanging over its taut mouth. Its torso, however, is massive, and its long arms are dauntingly powerful. You are going to fight it with a trident and net. Let's turn to 175 and see if you can be victorious.
Let's do this again, buddy.
You allow yourself a faint smile. You've chosen a good weapon with which to fight your adversary. Edged weapons cause little damage to the iron-like hide of a bone crusher beast. There's only way to slay a bone crusher beast, and that is to make it fall onto the ground, whereupon its delicate balance will be totally destroyed, and it will be impossible for the bone crusher to get to its feet again. You move cautiously to snare it with your weighted net. Roll one die. Turn to page 31. The bone crusher sniffs the air, senses where you're standing, and moves nimbly to its left, just as you release the net, which catches nothing but sand. Lose one luck point. You're now down you're down to seven luck. Roll two dice. That's less than your... Oh, that is the same as... That's the same as your skill. So turn to page 66. Your dexterity allows you to gather up the net while avoiding the sweeping arms of the bone crusher. Once again, you take aim and you hurl the net. Roll one dice.
Low or high? You won't tell me. A five.
A five. 189. Let's see what you got. 189. Your throw is on target. It lands on top of the near-sighted bone crusher and it thrashes around, becomes more and more entangled, and lets out an enraged howl. I don't have an enraged howl available, so I'm just gonna go.
Take that, brute!
Before it can break free, you tug hard and you pull the beast to the ground. The bone crusher lies helpless and defeated, panting with relief. You are taken back to your cell.
Absolutely, indeed. I can see no other outcome. Ha ha ha.
I'm watching that clock. Two more minutes. I need to survive two more minutes.
If he dies again, I'm gonna laugh my ass off.
Oh my goodness.
You guys are great. Can you come every week? This would be great. Okay, back to your cell, page 113. Let's see what happens. By the end of the day, only one other person returns to your cell. It's the mean-looking Easterner, a man who looks as though he would murder you for 2 copper pieces. As the light quickly fades...
Goodness, I have no coppers.
As the light quickly fades, a guard shouts out an unexpected command. There are now 2 of you left in each cell. I only want 1 to come out in the morning for tomorrow's combat. Sleep well. The guard bursts out laughing at his joke, and even before he's finished, the Easterner dives at you, brandishing a long, sharp pin, which was concealed in his headband. Unarmed, you must fight to the death. You've got this guy coming for you.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to end your life, cad.
Well, Thamiel, welcome in. Retro Ted, you trip on a stone and break your neck.
Probably.
Oh, Raven Pierce, welcome in. Oh, hail. I love the whole hail thing. If you have the swords up emotes, let me know that you're with me and you're on my side by using those. Okay, I am going to put on the battle music this time because we are going into battle with the Easterner. It was a skill of 10.
Oh dear.
And a stamina of 8. Mm-hmm. Woof. Right, guys. Do we think he can make it? I mean, he's beaten his quickest death time. He made it past 9:23, sure did. Let's get into battle. We're both going to roll our dice and add our skill. Get those re-rolls ready if you want to. But it seems like everyone
both
is
dice and adding
both dice and adding skill. Yes.
All right.
Team adventurers, yes. Excellent. Fabulous. Oh, no.
18.
I rolled snake eyes. I only got a 12, so you hit him. He's down to 6 stamina. An 18 from me this time.
This is a 15.
He hits you, I'm afraid. You take 2 damage.
All right.
Colleen wants to re-roll my dice. Okay, let's see what the outcome of this is. That is a 21. So would you like me to re-roll? I'm expecting so. We've got a 17.
And I rolled another 15.
Oof, he still hits you. Kalina's got a 15? Lot of points. Kalina's got a lot of points for rerolls. God damn it, I know, right? Okay, this time I rolled a 19. What did you get?
Crikey, a 17.
Ooh, he hits you again.
So I'm down to 15 stamina?
That's correct, yep. You lose 2 stamina, you lose every time he hits you. A 16 from me this time.
An 18. Okay. How about you, foreman?
It's on 4 stamina. We've got another reroll from Colleen. We can reroll that next time. Yeah, we've got a 21 again. Would you like me to reroll?
I got a 16.
I got a 15. You hit him. He's on 2 health. Thamiel, he has 9 skill. He has 15 stamina currently and 7 luck. Okay, I've rolled a 17, so he hits you.
So I'm down to 13.
Okay, and you have no provisions this time. You've got no way of healing yourself.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Okay, I rolled a 20.
I rolled a 15.
Would anyone like to re-roll my dice? Any re-rolls? 3.
Anyone? Please.
2.
Help me.
Okay, yeah, re-roll. Nice one.
Thank you.
A 15 here. What did you get, sorry?
A 15, so it's a push.
We nothing happens. Yeah, we just parry.
Alright. That leaves me at a 15.
Okay.
And how many stamina does he have left? 13?
He has 2 stamina left. You only need to hit him one more time. Yeah, you need to hit him once more. That's it. I rolled an 18 that time.
And I rolled an 18.
Nothing happens. We parry. This is a really tough fight.
I have your measure, brute. Prepare to die.
Yes, an 18.
A 19 here. He hits you.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Rigged! Rigged, I tell you! British author, British reader!
I rolled a 20.
I don't think I can even roll that.
Would
yep,
anyone...
17.
We've got another reroll in. Yep, here we go. Oh, snake eyes, 12. You hit him, you
nice.
Finish him off! He's dead! He's dead! He's dead! He's dead.
It's a fight, you. Oh, perfidious foe, and I am sorry to see you expire, but relieved at the same time.
If you win, turn to page 237. What do you think, guys? Shall we save there? Shall we call that a save point? I think so.
I am amazed at really how tension building that is. Like, you're just
The battles are like literally some of them I'm on the edge of my seat, especially when it's as close as that. Thamiel says I think that is a nice save point. Yeah, let the poor guy have a save point just in case we get that bonus life, guys. So the time is 13:58. I'll do it a couple of seconds early because I procrastinated with that. So I'll put you on 13. I'll put you on 13:50 because I did procrastinate. You have a skill of 9. What is your stamina at the moment, please?
11.
11. And a luck of 7.
Correct.
And guys who've just tuned in, Jolly's character has no weapons, no armor, no backpack, no provisions, no potions, no way of healing themselves at all. At all. So, there you go. Nervous Cabbage, I can't stay since I'm at work, but I hope everyone is really well. Good luck, adventurer. Nervous Cabbage is one of my favorite adventurers, and they will be taking part this season, which is great. Thamiel says loot that guy. That guy is also a slave who has nothing. So
he has a pin.
He has a pin, yeah, but looting him would actually be pretty pointless. Okay, let's get back into it.
I see what you did there.
Pointless! Oh my god, I didn't even know I was doing that. I'm funny and I don't know it. Lauren says, go Charlie!
Thank you, Lauren. DMs stick together.
Lauren,
she
a fellow
is a phenomenal DM.
Amazing.
Yeah, we're co-DMs in
Sweet.
DM Charlie Gaming. She's
amazing.
Fabulous. So
awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah, I've got a lot of points too, but maybe I want to hoard them. So I've given you an extra something this time. You've got the plus twos to the rolls. you have the plus two to the rolls, but you only get those twice. So guys in chat, make sure that you are using those, but use them wisely. Probably don't use them just yet. Use them wisely. Maybe when we go up against a real big boy. Malachi says, I need points to give to Vicky. So actually having the rerolls, sometimes if I've rolled really badly, so for example, I rolled that snake eyes just then, you could reroll my dice to try and help me out. So the rerolls don't necessarily help Charlie.
They help
me.
You can save those rerolls for when she's rolling boxcars.
The reroll are limitless. Yeah, rerolls are limitless, but the plus twos are limited to 2 per stream, so use them wisely. Okay, so yeah, it is interesting, isn't it? Wait until we go up against something actually dangerous. Yeah, we haven't done that yet. We're not even in the dungeon yet. We're just pre-dungeon. Cool. Right, let's get back into it. So you slump back against the cell wall after the fierce battle with the Easterner, and you fall asleep from pure exhaustion. When all the survivors are assembled in the arena in the morning, there are only 12 of you left. The first test of the day involves a deadly machine. You'll need lightning reactions and steel nerves to survive it. It's made of a pole fixed to a heavy base. 2 sharp blades stick out from either side of the pole, one at head height and one at ankle height. One of the slaves is made to stand by the pole, which is promptly spun around by one of the guards. The slave alternately has to duck under one blade and jump over the other to avoid being badly cut. Your turn comes last, and there are 9 survivors so far. The 2 others have had their throats cut. You stand by the pole, adrenaline pumping through your veins. The guard spins the pole, and you start to jump and duck. Roll 2 dice.
Right!
Oh, cocked die. A 4.
A 4. If that's less than your skill score, let's turn to page 94 and see what happens. Oh my goodness, thank you for that. Yay, we got a little subscriber there. Welcome officially to the Swords Up Club. Now you have some lovely emotes there. Kay says, I can't work out if this is Total Wipeout or Gladiators. It's a mix of both. Right, you get into a steady rhythm of ducking and jumping, and slowly the pole spins to a halt. You have survived another ordeal, but the next test begins immediately. You and the rest are split into 2 groups of 5. You watch the first group of a dwarf, a man-orc, a warrior woman, a barbarian, and a dark-skinned southerner stand silently as a spiked ball and chain is lashed to their sword arms, and a small shield is lashed to the other. They're then blindfolded and ordered to commence battle against one another until there is only one left standing. It's a sickening spectacle to watch as the fighters tread warily around the arena, swinging their balls and chains. The dwarf falls first, quickly followed by the warrior woman, and in the end, the southerner stands triumphant and his blindfold is removed. He's led away, and then each member of your group is armed in the same way. You can feel your heart pounding in your chest as the order is given to commence battle against the 4 unseen adversaries. Barefoot in the sand, nobody makes a sound. Do you wish to step left, or do you wish to step right?
Oh my god. What kind of choice is this? I will always step to the right. So I go left.
You take a step to the left. Page 297. Even Killer Kitten says left. Let's see, 297. Thank you guys.
Over left is hopefully correct, Samuel.
You step slowly to your left, straining your ears for the sound of any movement. Suddenly, there's an agonized cry and a dull thud as a body falls to the ground, not far in front of you. So, a body's fallen in front of you. Do you wish to step further to the left, or stand your ground and swing your ball and chain?
Stand my ground and swing.
Stand your ground and swing. Page 131. Just as you begin to swing the ball and chain, one of the other combatants steps up behind you, swinging his weapon. Test your luck. So we've got our first test of luck. You need to roll both dice, and it needs to be 7 or below.
A 5!
You are lucky. But now that you've had to use your luck, you lose a bit of luck, so your luck goes down to 6. But
not
you...
even in the damnable dungeon yet.
Not even in the dungeon yet. You are lucky. Turn to 148. You make first contact and your unseen opponent cries out in pain as a spiked ball slams into his shoulder, but you don't hear him fall. You turn your head, listening intently for another grunt or groan. The man has bitten his lip and makes no sound. If you wish to stay where you are and continue to swing, you can, or you can take a step to your left. It's like nightmare, isn't it?
Wants me to go left. Stay where I am. I hit him. He's gonna assume that I move. I'm gonna stand my ground and swing.
Stand your ground and swing. Page 159. You decide to crouch down and swing low, hoping that your opponent will swing his weapon over your head. Test your luck. You have a luck of 6. You need to roll a 6 or below. This is tense.
You think? 7.
You are unlucky, but you've used your luck, so it goes down to 5. But you are unlucky. Page 102. This could be the end for our adventurer.
Not again.
This could be the end, guys. Unfortunately for you, your tactics fail. Your opponent changes tactics too, and he swings his ball and chain downwards rather than above his head. Test your luck again. You have a luck of 5. You need to roll a 5 or below. Oh my god, this is so dense. If you have those tense emotes, then spam And this is before he even gets into the dungeon, guys.
That would be a good time for a plus 2. A plus 2. That would be a good time.
No, because you need to roll below your luck to be lucky.
I know. Oh, yeah. That would be a good time for a minus 2.
Your luck now goes down to 4. You are unlucky.
Primony.
283. This could be the end.
This is brutal.
This is awful. 283.
Oh,
and we don't have a bonus life for you yet either. 283.
Oh. No. You did. Oh my god.
With a sickening crunch, the spiked ball thuds into your skull, killing you instantly before you even hit the sand. The arena of death claims another victim.
This was fun.
Oh my god. This is the shortest stream I've ever done. Wow.
Keep rubbing it in, Vicky. Keep rubbing it in.
What are we going to do for another... What are we going to do, guys?
Sing campfire songs. Do rounds, you know?
Oh my god. This is just... I'm so sorry.
I earned that. Don't be. I remember as a kid, you know, the original 4 from Steve Jackson. And, you know, 3 pages in, you're dead. Starting over again. Oh, I made it 5 pages in. Yeah, so it's fun. What a capricious bit of nonsense.
You didn't even make it to the dungeon.
Believe me. You think I... Yep. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I have a feeling that this is going to be a topic of dinner conversation for some time to come.
This is
great.
Matter
of fact, I have a feeling that 5 years from now is... Remember that time when you didn't even make it into the dungeon? I'll do the dishes!
Oh my gosh. Killer Kitten says, kill him again. Unfortunately, we didn't get the bonus life. We need a £10 donation. I don't think the donate link has come up, so let me see if I can trigger that manually. Can I do it manually? Will it do it? It just says if you'd like to support me, you can. But if we get that donation, if we get a £10 donation, you don't have to donate the whole £10. You could donate a little bit. If we can get a bonus life, I will kill him again. or we can just end. Bet you wish you had a tiny hut. I don't know what that means, but sure.
Okay, so since we're filling time, and thank you very much, Llama. Thank you. So she's in a campaign. They have Liamin's tiny hut, and I have unfortunately let her party use it a bit excessively, and they sometimes use it to my frustration and consternation, and now they kind of like to rub my nose and it like, we use tiny hut, and it's like, you know, just those
it's
like things
a get out of jail free card. Stray Maiden says, so now we turn the tables and Vicky plays. You know, Stray Maiden, I did that in the last season, because no one could complete the Eye of the Dragon last season, so I ended up having a go, because I won last season. I couldn't even beat it.
Yeah, but after how many runs?
I didn't officially beat it. I cheated because I'm a sore loser. And I was like, just let me get to the end so I can find out where this bloody eye is. So I cheated. But I did it all in full cosplay and all of that. So it was great. But yes, I did enjoy that stream. Thank you, Stray Maiden. So if no one wins this season, maybe I'll do it again. But for now, I think that's it. That's the shortest we've ever done. Wow.
I'm sorry to disappoint.
I have had a lot of fun torturing and killing you, even though you didn't make it into the dungeon. Lord Karnas is very disappointed. I mean, he has no champion now to send into the dungeon. And also, chat, you guys were incredible. You were so trolly today, so mean, and I love it. So if you could come back every week and be that mean to all of my adventurers, that would be fantastic. Right. There's no disappointing in this, no, exactly. Tiny Hut also gives your enemies time to prepare for when they get out. Yeah, I know, yes, right? You can only stay in there so long, I assume.
8 hours.
Eight hours. Okay. That's 8 hours for your opponents to rest and plan and plot.
You can be used to excellent effect, especially if the big bads cast darkness on the outside of it, so the adventurers inside have no idea what's going on just outside.
Oh, that's fantastic. That is fantastic.
Yeah, absolutely.
So guys, we're going to do this for another 10 weeks. So this actually runs until the start of April. I'm going to take one break, one planned break, which is for my birthday in the middle of February. We actually have, I think, two or three slots left, which are in my Discord and on my Twitter as well. But we actually have a space for next week. So if someone wants to come on, if someone's available and they think that they'd be a great adventurer and that we'd get on really well and that you'd be entertaining, and you want to have a go at the Trial of Champions, then let me know. We can possibly get you on next week.
Caveat, if you think you need a lesson in humility.
Llama says, I love your stream, though I usually lurk through them. That's absolutely fine. That's no problem. Lurkers are very welcome. I lurk a lot of streams. I lurk a lot of streams because I usually watch them while I'm working. So I lurk a lot. So thank you. Thamior needs a lesson, okay. all of those are not possible for me. That's fine. That's okay. Otherwise, I'm just going to have to rope my boyfriend in to be a victim, which I know he enjoys. So we'll see. Watch this space. But what I've got to say as well is if there is no adventurer, then there is no stream. So I really do need people to come on. This is my little beg. This is my little beg. Fabulous. Excellent.
I've watched her streams, and she is in our Discord server.
Can you vouch? Okay.
Yeah, cool. I will vouch for her, and also I want a chance at some payback. Yeah, bring her on. I'll be watching. I will be watching.
Cool. All right. Well, let's make that happen. Wicked. Awesome. If you vouch, then that's cool. Awesome. That's what happened with Colleen. Colleen Ali. Me and Colleen had actually never met or spoken or anything before, and someone was like, "You need to get Colleen on," and that's what happened. And I absolutely love Colleen as a guest now, and now we're married. So. Twitch married.
Retro Ted wants to.
I'd be up for setting a death speedrun time. Wicked. Again, send me a PM or a DM or whatever you call them, and hit me up and we'll try and sort something out. I've got, I think, two or three slots left for the season, but for now, I'm afraid that is it. That's the end of today's stream. Quickest death.
I'm so sorry.
I have recorded that as 9 minutes 23 as the quickest death. You might just get the booby prize, a pack of stickers or something.
And you're so nice on your Sirenscape sound that roulette stream.
I know.
You're tricky. Tricky.
Tricky Vicky is one of my nicknames. Vicky. Tricky Vicky is one of my nicknames. But yeah, I'm a really nice person. This is the only time that I get to be a little bit mean. This is the only
just
time
vent all your spleen.
I love it. Stray Maiden says marketing versus reality. Thing is, I don't know if I could get away with being this mean on a Sirenscape stream.
That would be hilarious. Well, I'll add that. Oh, that's absolute bucket. No, that will suck. You know, we're not adding that.
Oh, you're being a wanker now. Stop it.
Sorry.
Sorry, I know
I... I'm not... Oh, okay.
No, it's just... Oh my gosh! Who donated £10? Throm!
Here we go Throm again.
Donated. Thank you, Throm. You will be avenged. No end of stream. No, I was literally just about to wrap up. Oh my gosh. Okay. It looks like your torture is about to continue if you are up for it, Charlie. I'm going to give you the option.
Yeah.
Would you like to continue?
No, absolutely. Okay. He paid his £10, and I will give him £10 of my pain and torture and embarrassment. So here we go again.
Excellent. Okay, let me edit the timer. We are going back to when you just killed the Easterner. So we're not going all the way back to the start. We're actually going back to 13 minutes and 50 seconds. Let's see if that resets properly. Do you want to update them? No. 13 minutes 50. I think that looks about right. The timer is ever so weird this season. Let's make it 3 deaths in the arena. All right, let's grab that bonus heart there. Bonus life. Ow, I didn't do the thing. Here we go. We need to actually do... we actually need to do something cool. Which is this thing, and I always forget to do it, but it is pretty cool. Are you ready for this? It's got a little sound that goes with it. There we go. We've got a bonus life. We need more torture. Fantastic. Well, thank you to Throm, whoever you are. Throm is one of my favourite heroes from Death Trap Dungeon. You will be avenged. You will be. If anyone has played Death Trap Dungeon, the fight with Throm where you have to fight your buddy, you have to kill your friend, that is like, so sad, so sad. Right, let's see if we can make it past, let's see if we can make it into the dungeon, shall we? So we are going back to page 237, we've just defeated the Easterner.
So I have 7 luck.
You have 9, you've got 9 skill, full stamina, and 7 luck, not 11 luck. Oof. 7 luck.
7 luck.
7
and
luck.
Full stamina.
Full stamina. Yeah.
Nice.
And you are...
I have to fight the Easterner again?
No. You've killed him. Okay. You've just killed him. So thank you. I'm really, really glad. Charlie, I've got to say, I'm glad that I've had you on today. I'm really, really glad that you volunteered for this. I'm really enjoying this. You've brought some good people into my chat who seem to be enjoying this as well. Thamior, his maximum stamina is 19. Thank you for tracking that. Okay, let's go, shall we? We are on page 237. Let us begin.
You were absolutely correct in that I needed an eraser for this morning.
Yes, absolutely. You slump back against the cell wall after the fierce fight with the Easterner, and you fall asleep from pure exhaustion. When all the survivors are assembled in the arena in the morning, there are only 12 of you left. The first test of the day involves a deadly machine. You'll need lightning-fast reactions and steel nerves to survive it. It is a pole fixed to a heavy base. 2 sharp blades stick out from either side of the pole, one at head height and one at ankle height. One of the slaves is made to stand by the pole, which is promptly spun around by one of the guards. The slave alternately has to duck under one blade and jump over the other to avoid being badly cut. Your turn comes last, and there are 9 survivors so far. 2 others have had their throats cut. You stand by the pole, adrenaline pumping through your veins. The guard spins the pole and you start to jump and duck. Roll 2 dice.
Now it's a 10.
Oh, it's greater than your skill score. Whoopsies. 3, 2, 4. Greater than your skill.
Well spent donation. Yeah, well spent donation.
We can't have you die just yet. We can't have you die just yet. 3, 2, 4. Let's hope it's not a death. Let's hope it's not a death.
I actually
don't want you to die. Fuck no. I'm not going to kill you. I can't do it. I can't do it. No. Try again. Roll 2 dice. Zub, 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 zub. We're just rewinding.
Hey! Snake eyes.
Come on. Okay, it's less than your skill score. I cannot kill him off that quick. That wouldn't be a good use of £10. Okay. Page 94. Page 94. Come on. 94. Can't kill you off just yet. You get into the steady rhythm of ducking and jumping. You did have a near miss, though. Had a near miss. But now the pole spins to a halt. You've survived, just about. Another ordeal. The next test begins immediately. You and the rest are split into two groups of five. You watch the first group of a dwarf, a man-orc, a warrior woman, a barbarian, and a dark-skinned southerner as they stand silently as a spiked ball and chain is lashed to each of their sword arms and a small shield is lashed to their other hand. They are then blindfolded in order to commence battle against one another until there is only one left standing. It's a sickening spectacle to watch. The fighters tread warily around the arena, swinging their balls and chains. The dwarf falls first, quickly followed by the warrior woman. In the end, the southerner stands triumphant and his blindfold is removed. He's led away, and then each of your group is armed in the same way. You can feel your heart pounding in your chest as the order is given to commence combat against the four unseen adversaries. Barefoot in the sand, nobody makes a sound. Do you wish to step to your left or to your left. Right? Left,
I
please.
I step can... to the left.
Take a step to the left.
I'm only
297. You step slowly to your left, straining your ears for the sound of movement. Suddenly, there is an agonized cry and a dull thud as a body falls to the ground not far in front of you. Do you wish to step further to the left? Or would you rather stand your ground and swing your ball and chain?
Yes, I absolutely want to step to the left this time.
Left, 368. Yes. 368. Someone just shouted, left, left, left! So we can chant, you're gonna die. Yes, you can. You're gonna die. You're gonna die. You're gonna die. And Malachisa says, you were only saved by the fact that that was a donated life. Yes, absolutely.
I'm aware. Yeah. I'm so aware.
You walk slowly on to the left. You stop and listen again. You hear nothing, and you decide to walk in the opposite direction. Test your luck. You have a luck of seven. You need
seven.
To roll seven or below.
Seven.
Okay, you rolled seven or... Yeah, wicked. Your luck goes down to six. But you are lucky. You turn to page 166. Unknown to you, there's a body lying in the sand directly in your path, and you're fortunate not to trip over it as you pass by. You decide to stand still for a moment and listen. You hear the whooshing sound of a ball and chain being whirled through the air directly in front of you. So remember, you've stepped over a body. You were lucky not to trip. Do you want to stand your ground and swing your own ball and chain, step backwards, or lie down in the sand and try to trip the person who is advancing on you?
Counterintuitive. I shall try lying in the sand and creating an obstacle.
316.
Are you kidding me?
You
Are
lie
you
down.
Kidding me?
You lie down in the sand and you hear a shouted order. Shoot the coward! Let me see if I've got a lovely... do I have... Let's see, what does this one do? How about this one? I don't know what that was. That was supposed to be an arrow in flesh.
Yeah,
you
it's
panic.
Pretty squishy and quiet.
It is squishy and quiet, isn't it?
It is.
That was a shame. Oh, where is that? Where am I at? Where is it?
Global
come
one on. Shots on the top, right after the.
Oh, I see it! I see it! I see it! I see it! Come on! yes. Malachisa says, "Oh, that face!" And Colleen says she has a special smile for that. Just so you know, you're lying down in the sand, you hear a shouted order, shoot the coward! You panic and you try to get your feet, but two arrows are fired by unseen archers and they sink into your chest. You slump headlong into the sand, and you do not stir again. That pleases the crowd.
Fighting fantasy is dumb.
The crowd are very happy. Yeah, the crowd are very happy with that.
Including
very, very
my
happy.
Wife. My wife. Oh my god, I just. Wow.
Brutal. That is fucking brutal.
Wow, I just made all the wrong decisions every single step of the way.
To be honest, I thought lying down would have been a really good option.
Yeah.
I thought it was a sound strategy. Clearly not.
I couldn't even make it out of the arena.
Nope.
Oh, my Lanta. My Lanta.
Nope.
You're feeling a little embarrassed for me, aren't you? Because I'm definitely feeling embarrassed for
myself. I'm just like, fuck me. That is brutal. Like, at least Phoenixy Wacky last week made it through. Like,
yeah.
He actually made it into the dungeon. You failed at every step. Like, you had a very near miss, like, as well with the pole. Oh, my God. Yeah.
Four deaths in an hour. Yeah.
Four deaths in an hour. Well, three deaths.
Epic.
Yeah, three deaths. Nearly four. Nearly four.
Criminy. What was that you were saying about him having three lives was too many?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
You failed at literally everything. Oh my gosh. Brutal,
well, I mean,
guys.
It's
brutal.
Not as though breaking it apart mechanically, it is down to randomness the whole way, and then, you know, a binary choice. So you've got, so I don't feel, yes, I am going to be in a depressed funk for the rest of
no,
the day.
No, you're not. You did great. You know what? You've entertained all of us as if we were spectators in the crowd, in the arena of death. You really took us there. Pamplemousse Press as well. That'll be one for the bloopers reel. Yeah.
Please don't excuse your poor decision-making.
Oh, bless.
Oh, Maui. I know I've made many, many poor decisions.
Kay says, Charlie gets his own special leaderboard made out of the back of a cereal box. You know what? I'm not going to make you a fancy certificate. I'm literally just going to put it on toilet paper. Mail it to you. There you go.
I kind of was asking for it with giving such a pretentious adventurer's name, you know, Aubrey Edmund Horatio.
He really needed he needed taking down a peg or two for sure.
Right. Who are you playing now? Grok the survivor. Yeah. No, that was awesome. Thank you very, very much, Vicky, for allowing me to come on your stream and try this.
You are very welcome. You're very, very welcome. You were great. Absolutely fine.
You
surpassed all of my expectations of you. I'm going to give you a shout out now. If you could just remind everybody who you are, if you could
absolutely.
Just remind people who you are, what you stream, where they can find you, and if you've got anything coming up, now's your time to promote it.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, so tomorrow night, Sunday, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern, that will be like I think Monday. Down there, down under, we are streaming Rime of the Frost Maiden, a Twitch experiment. We are like episode 7. The guys have just made it into the Lost Spire of Netheril, and the rogue has just been turned to stone. So, I too enjoy getting my own on players. I am also the face of DM Charlie Gaming. We are a group of GMs and pro DMs. We have a wonderful community on Discord. If you pop over to our stream channel, there is a link to the Discord. Very active, a lot of 35 years up gamers, very supportive, very inclusive. We have one shots coming. Most of the campaigns for the season have started, but I know a couple more campaigns will be starting up here in a week or two. I think we have another Icewind Dale and a couple that the DMs are discussing getting started up. So there's opportunity to game. We do free one-shots like every month, you know, so people can just play. GMs can run games that are free to play and stuff. For streaming, I'm going to be expanding probably end of next month, first part of March. We'll be expanding to another stream. And then coming March 11th, I'm very excited. Malakisa will actually be one of my players we will be streaming a one-shot. Coots!
Agent Treachery will always overcome youth and skill!
Where all of the adventurers are going to be elderly.
Oh my god.
So it should be.
Please, can I get in on that?
Yeah. If you wanna play, I'll send you the stuff. I'm just getting things set up, but it's
if we can find the time, if the time works out, because obviously the time difference is quite a lot. But I would even dress up as my old lady Biddy for that. I actually have a character called Biddy. She used to stream. She used to sing.
Nice.
MC Biddy.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Does everyone remember MC Biddy? anyone who's followed me from way back in the day will remember MC Biddy. I'll bring MC Biddy back for one shot.
That would be cool. That'd be very cool.
If we can make that happen, I would bring Biddy back for a one shot.
I'll invite you into that room, and we'll see if it all can work. And
wicked.
I'm pretty excited because one of the players, he will be doing everything with Thaco in the old AD&D rules and refusing to use 5e. Yeah.
So. Okay.
But that's us. That's what we do.
Refusing 5e? Why?
An old person thing.
Thaco, I see.
Back in the AD&D days. Yeah.
I'm too young to remember that.
You didn't miss much. It was it was special. It was very
special. Okay, cool. Well, I will have to learn rules.
Won't.
Okay. Wicked. Colleen, how have you only followed me for a year and 2 months? It's got to be longer than that. It must be longer than that. Bringing Biddy back, just like, yes, I'm bringing Biddy back. Yes, she's a very British old lady who speaks like this and loves to drink tea. And she's got a very dirty mouth. She loves the F word. She loves to say fuck and bugger and wanker and tosspot. But yes, wicked. All right. Yeah, she does a lot of this. She's very uncouth. But yes, I think, is that everything you need to promote for here?
Yeah, and I also forgot. Oh, yeah. On Thursdays, I am also on Phoenix Iwaki's Wild Beyond the Witchlight campaign as Willy Grimm.
You know what?
I am a fate-touched warlock.
And it's great. I watched part one. I haven't managed to catch the second session yet, but I will because I'm very excited for everything Wild Beyond the Witchlight. And Willy,
cool.
Everyone was like, Willy? And you're like, yes, Willy!
Really grim, yeah.
Really, yeah, it's fantastic. So awesome.
Thank
I will
you.
Definitely.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun with it.
And I'm a big fan of Scarlett's song. She did my emotes for me, so obviously I'm watching for her as well. So yeah, I'm very much enjoying that so far. Wicked.
It's a good one. Thank you very much.
No worries.
Right on. This was very, very fun, Vicky.
Thank you. You were a great guest. Absolutely fantastic guest. So I'm going to say goodbye to you. If you want to hang around, we can have a chat afterwards just where we are. So just mute yourself for now, and I'll see you in just a few minutes. I'm just going to do my sign off. So everyone say thank you to Charlie. Goodbye, Charlie.
Bye, Twitch Sphere. Bye.
Oh, that was wonderful. So I could probably update my leaderboard now, live, if we would like to. Let's do it, shall we? Shall we put Charlie on there as eliminated? Would everyone like to see that happen? Rip, I know, oh my goodness, how awful. Let's have a little look. Case, you followed me for 2 years, 2 months. You basically have been here from the start because I didn't start streaming. I'm just coming up to my 2 years streamiversary. So that's fantastic. You are like a long time follower. I'm just going to put eliminated on here. Eliminated. And Case makes a lot of my clips as well. So thank you so much. That's why you've got your VIP diamond there, Case. Making all those clips for me, which eventually go into the reel. I didn't even get to show you my clips reel. So would you be happy for me to put on the clips reel? And when we come back, you'll see the leaderboard. Would you like to see the clips reel? Is that something that you'd like to see maybe? Or shall I put that on at the end? I don't know. We didn't even get a chance to do the be right back screen. Kay says, I think I first followed when you only did offline sings things. Yeah, exactly. You want to see the clips reel? Cool. I'll probably only give you part of the clips reel and then I'll update the leaderboard and you'll see that DM Charlie Gaming has been eliminated. So just bear with me. I'll just show you a few clips from last season and I'll be right back in a few minutes. If you decide to stay, you may have to face your fears.
Wait a minute, let me get my tea. Ready.
What's the worst that could happen?
This whole campaign is trouble.
I want to hear your Scottish accent.
It's not Scottish! No, it's not! Let me see if I can get some lovely sound effects for your torture.
Listen very carefully. I shall say this only once.
Eye of the Dragon, more like Kanye. Kanye Eye of the Dragon.
Pitiful. A pitiful.
Play ya ding dong. It makes me ever so thirsty. Play it! Need to drink, goddammit! Go on. You all have some leaf paste, won't you, fathers? Go on. I don't want to do this anymore! It made me feel like a little baby now. Right, anyway, that's a weird thing to say. No! You made me feel like a little baby. Oh, I knew this was gonna happen. I should have had second breakfast. I was gonna have second breakfast, but I didn't.
You didn't have second breakfast.
I didn't have second breakfast. No! I had a very small first breakfast, and I'm starving, hungry. So please die soon.
It's gonna be the shortest stream ever.
Hey, would you like my head? Wear this helmet. See if it's cursed.
My curiosity got me killed twice. Let's get killed again.
Okay, please die. Are you dead? Your adventure.
No! You're joking.
Death. I love death.
How was anyone meant to beat her?
Professional killer at this point. Is that enough for you?
The next creature I see, I'm just gonna lay there and take it.
What? I thought that we were family friendly. I guess not.
Quick, pull out your dog. He's just gonna watch his mate, Morningstar, you to death.
I'm just gonna let them kill me.
We might eat you afterwards.
How barbaric an option.
Bloody hell. This got dark.
Oh, that was ruthless.
I feel like I've actually been squishy and all my dicks got squished. My beautiful dick collection.
It's still phallic. That still makes me happy. Starting to feel a little bit deja vu-ish. I actually think I'm going to leave the clips reel there so that you can see Charlie's name on the leaderboard there.
Eliminated.
It always looks different. It looks different on there than it does on my end. So that's really strange. But yeah, I've had to make Charlie's name a lot smaller just to fit it on. But thanks guys for sticking around. I really hope that you enjoyed that episode. Charlie was a fantastic guest. So I'm just going to give them one more shout out. So you can go and follow my guest today. Go and give them a follow. We're going to wrap it up. We do this every week with a new guest every week. Malakisa, I'm hoping to have you on. We'll check your DMs. We'll have a little chat. We'll see if we can work out timings and all of that. That would be great. So, yeah, we're going to do this every week with a new guest. So join me next week to see who is going to be taking on the Trial of Champions. Killer Kitten, thank you for being here as well. Shouldn't he be number 12? Is it by survival time or appearance time? At the moment, it's literally just whoever's eliminated goes at the bottom. There's no time. The only people who will go at the top are the people who make it through and who have like an actual survival time. But I thought it'd be nice to just honor those who were eliminated by putting them at the bottom. But I can change those round if that would make you happier, Case. Because to be honest, I think Charlie should really be at the bottom, right? Quickest death. So yeah, once again, thanks so much for Sirenscape for doing the sound and all of that. Serum 76, for some reason you're because you called someone a loser, it got held by Automod. It's only going to be 12 episodes. Yeah, it is. It's only going to be 12 episodes. Thamior, yes. So the season usually is 12 episodes long. We have 12 guests. So, yeah, second is the first loser. There we go. So that's the leaderboard. I'm really glad that we've got a leaderboard this season. But yes, thank you to Sirenscape for doing the sound. If you didn't know, you can actually custom make your own sound sets. I like to make my own custom sound sets. I put hours into making them, so this one was custom. If you want to go and grab some epic sounds for your epic tabletop role-playing games, they make the official sounds of D&D, Pathfinder, Starfinder, Call of Cthulhu, and Cyberpunk Red, if that's your kind of thing. Or if you're doing something completely different or homebrewing something, then you can make your own stuff as well. If you have any questions about it, just ask. Please. That was a well-timed timer right there. Go and grab yourself a free trial at sirenscape.com. If you need any help with it, just ask, because I do work for them. Surprise. And yeah, that's it, really. Thanks to Ian for making the book as well. Obviously, big shout out to Ian. Ian just got knighted, Sir Ian Livingstone. And join me next week, same time, to see if someone else can defeat the Trial of Champions and take home a copy of the book. Again, I haven't got a raid target. I really should get better at this. Let me see who else is on that I could perhaps raid. Back to Twitch. Let's have a little look, shall we? Who's on? Who could I raid? let's have a little look. He did do pretty badly. Yeah, he did. Arrow in Flesh. Phoenixy Wacky is on. Maybe we could go and raid Phoenix. That'd be nice. What's he playing today? Which campaign is he? Is he running? Let's have a little look. My Twitch is taking ages to load, but I really appreciate you all being here. Obviously, I did take a massive break. I did take a massive break from streaming, so it's been really nice to come back. I'm hoping to be streaming more from April, so stick around. If you love RPG stuff, I plan to be playing some solo RPGs. I plan to be playing some solo RPGs and some like Pathfinder, maybe some Pathfinder something or other. And also I want to play some of the fighting fantasy and sorcery video games as well. So hopefully I'll be doing that in April. So from April. So yeah, solo RPG is nice. So actually, fighting fantasy is a solo game, but I won't be playing any more of that. But I do have a really nice solo RPG called Colossal, which is like, you draw cards to go on your adventure and you make a journal as you go. So I think that could be a really nice chill kind of thing to do as we go through that. So that's the plan. If you want to join my Discord, we have lots of cool conversation going on in there about board games, video games, fighting fantasy, anything really. So feel free to join the Discord if you really want to. I'm quite active in there. And yeah, I think let's go and raid Phoenix. Phoenix is our guest last week. It's very rare that I get a chance to raid. So let's go a raiding. Raid Phoenix Iwaki. They are good people. Phoenix and his crew and all of his guests are fantastic. So let's go raiding Phoenix Iwaki. Let's get the raid call ready. I am going to raid and run. I'm actually going to be catching up with Charlie. And going to go to the loo. So, yeah, get your raid calls ready, guys. We've got a raid going there. Raid and run, raid and run. There we go. It is going to be a raid and run. Even I need to copy that. There we go, my darlings. Do I have a sub raid set up as well? Maybe? I think I have sub raids set up, perhaps. Yes, there we go. I've got a raid and run set up for my subs. I forgot that I'd done that. So, thank you all for being here. I do this the same time every Saturday. So please pop along if you enjoyed this. I'd love to see you next week. And thanks, guys. Go and enjoy the rest of your day and show some love to Phoenix Iwaki. Bye, everybody. Bye.